Hello everyone, my name is Hari Mohan Rai from Krishna Engineering College, belongs to Electronics and Communication Engineering Department. And I am making a video on smart home for environment sustainability. I belong to Ghaziabad, Uttar Pradesh, and the purpose things which I am going to use the software and process instruments is smart home. It is the part of this video is the part of international FDP on environment and sustainability, which is with the, in association with the UNESCO chair and open technology and well as United Nations Education Scientific and Cultural Organization. So let us begin with first of all, I'll include the first and second week of video. In the first week of the video, which was on based on IoT for environmental sustainability, that means Internet of Things for environmental sustainability. So in week one video, just I have made on how IoT can be used for environmental sustainability. Internet of Things is nothing but making things smart will be able to detect something which is producing more carbons and which is nothing but causes more impact on the environment. I have also talked about what are the area available where we can use the IoT devices to reduce the carbon emissions and all. So, and in the second week, I have talked about Industry 4.0 for environmental sustainability. So in Industry 4.0, just we have seen where today is this nothing but emerging area, Industry 4.0, where everywhere it is being used in industry, in transportation and all those things. So all those sectors. So here in week two also, I have talked about Industry 4.0 for environmental sustainability. And this both video, was nothing but the part of this international FDP. Now in continuation of that, we are going to talk about in this video that how we can simply design a smart home for environmental sustainability so that a home can be very much environment sustainable and as well as it should emit less amount of carbon. So video outcome, after going through this video, if any students or whomever the learners will be able to learn, understand what about the use of electronics equipment for environmental sustainability. For example, if you are using LED bulb, LED TVs and all those things, how we can make it environment sustainable. Learn to calculate the carbon footprint of the home appliances. This is the main part of this video that where we are nothing but going to learn. A learner is going to learn how to calculate the carbon footprints of your home appliances. And then apply the concept to improve the standard of equipment, like how we can choose some equipments of what kind of equipment so that our efficiency can be improved and carbon emission can be reduced. Then final step to design, we're able to design a smart home for the environmental sustainability so that less amount of carbon could be reduced or greenhouse gases should be as low as possible. Now in this slide we'll just little bit talk about what are the some IOC standard for electrical and electronic industries, because we are talking about electrical equipment, home appliances equipment, and about how to design a home. So we'll just briefly talk about what are the some IOC standards. So first of all, IOC standard is 9001:2050. It is for quality management system. This is applicable for all kind of industries to maintain the quality management of organization or any industries. Now the second ISO standard is 14001:2015. It is nothing but environmental management system. That means any organization, how effectively it is using or ensuring, it is nothing but to ensure that whether they are following the environmental standard or not, and they are making their I mean, their organization less negative impactful to the environment. Then OHSAS 18,000 2007, it is nothing but occupational health and safety management. It was for the employee health and safety purposes, so that whomever it is working on this, on the organization should be, organization should take care of their health and safety. Second, it was modified and it was named as 45001 2018. And this IOC standard is also for occupational health and safety management. It was nothing but extension of the previous one, OHSAS 18001 2007. Then the next one is 27001 and 2013. It was for information security management system. But basically, it is required for any organization to adopt efficient method for identifying the risk of its information security. So, information security is to secure the information security, this standard was being launched. Then there was a 10002 and 2004 ISO standard, which was nothing but compliant management system, where all the organizations should have process of efficient complaint handling process. So this was all about IOC standard for electrical and electronic industry, which we have talked about IoT as well as Industry 4.0. So IoT and Industry 4.0, these both are nothing but involved in the electrical and electronic industry. So these all should follow this ISO standard and for electrical and electrical industry. So before going to the next step, I mean, to design your sustainable homes, what we are going to see that how the global greenhouse gases emission by economic sector impacting. Why we are focusing on this smart home and design a smart home, a smart room, a smart organization? Because if you see this, the nothing but electricity and health production, heat production is nothing but 25% is nothing but greenhouse gases is being emitted. And the second portion is nothing but agriculture and forestry and other land uses. That means the most portion of greenhouse gases is being generated from the heat as well as electricity. So it means that we have to work on the electricity consumption and electricity use, especially industry, homes, and all those area. But first of all, we are starting from our home itself. Similarly, we can see here. Here also, if we check out the second reference slide, here also it is talked about that electricity consumption is nothing but being used 23% of total. I mean, greenhouse gases being emitted. 23.44% just because of electricity consumption. Hence, we have to work on this area to reduce the electricity consumption so that the carbon emission can be reduced. So for that purpose, first of all, we'll learn what is carbon footprint and how it is being calculated. So carbon footprint is basically defined as the total emission of greenhouse gases. The greenhouse gases by an individual or an event or by an organization or by a product, and it is expressed by carbon dioxide equivalent. Basically, methane and mostly we can say methane as well as carbon dioxide are the main part of the greenhouse gases which create the carbon footprints. So we learn here what are the formula, how the formulation of carbon footprint calculation, and the next slide we'll see that how to calculate the carbon footprint. So let us see why we are focusing on it, because before designing it any kind of home, so we know that what is the what is the process of carbon footprint calculations. So here we can see that to calculate the carbon footprint of electricity, we use the formula kilowatt hours per year into energy efficient, we can say this one. So it means that because carbon footprint is being calculated in per year in kilowatt per hour, and it is being calculated kilowatt per hour into electric efficient factor here, where EF is also called electricity emission factor, which is given by every area, every country, and equipment. So it is nothing but kilowatt per year into emission factor, you can say electricity emission factor, and that will give you the emission of carbon footprint in kilogram, which is CO2 carbon dioxide emission per year. Okay, similarly for natural gases we use therms per year, and then it is nothing but emission factor, and then we are getting calculated in kilogram CO2 per year. Similarly for fuel, LPG, waste and water, these are the formula to calculate the CO2 emission per year. CO2 emission, carbon footprint, basically we are calculating on the basis of carbon carbon dioxide. So fuel oil we are taking liters per year, and similarly it is taking LPG is also liters per year, waste it is kilogram per week, water in liters per day, and these are the for every others factors we are taking emission factor here, but in waste and water we are taking week for week, we are multiplying with 52, and for water we are multiplying with 365, because it is being calculated per day and is calculated per week. So in next slide we'll see how we are being calculated. This is not just only formula. Again we'll see one statistics where we have compared the LED, CFLs and incandescent bulb in the terms of carbon footprints. So you see here the LEDs bulb in terms of carbon footprint, it is generating 514 lbs of CO2 per year. Okay, whereas CFLs it is nothing but more than double, approximately double, we can say exactly double lbs per year. And when we'll go for the normal classical bulb which were being used previously, it is nothing but 4,405 lbs CO2 per year. And when we convert it to the kilowatt hours, you just see that it is nothing but we just divided by 1000, it will be nothing but 0.2 kilowatt hours. This will be nothing but 0.3 kilowatts per hour, or this is nothing but 1.65 kilowatts hour. So this we can say that when we use LED bulb, so it can save at least 50% as compared to the CFL, and more than 10%, matlab 10 times of the incandescent bulbs, isn't it? So we'll prefer to use LED in our home automation. Similarly, there are some comparison of televisions, like plasma televisions and LED televisions. Just we'll see one or two. You see that 24-inch television with this brand is nothing but using 32 watt of electricity consumption. Okay, whereas this Panasonic, if you're taking approximately 34 watt of plasma television, it is taking 165 to 200 watt electricity consuming. So see that how many times it is. If you're using some other brand and other not non-energy efficient products, then how much it consumes the electricity, as well it is causes the carbon emissions. And here just we have shown finally that some LCD television, if you are using the LCD television of 31 inch, and it is also consuming approximately 95 watt to 165 watt typically in terms of power consumption. So going through this all slide, we found out that the energy consumption is nothing but have to be reduced when we are going to design a home automation, any home, a smart home, where the main factor is to less carbon emission, as well as it should be efficient for everyone, isn't it? So next slide, what we are going to see that we are going to see the how we calculate the carbon footprint of a of any home appliances system. So what we will just will do a task here. We'll see like we know that all electrical appliances in our home nothing but generate greenhouse gases. For example, ke liye we'll count out the our lighting, light fittings, computers, heaters, fridges, radio, your smart boards, everything, whatever we are is being used in our homes, nothing but it is the cause of greenhouse gases. Okay, so we'll calculate one right now and we'll check that how it is being calculated. You can calculate by your own also. And there are many sites also where you can by using that you can calculate. In the previous slides I have just shown here, by you if you'll go to this slide, I mean this site, that is carbonfootprint.com calculator. Here you can calculate your carbon footprint generation of your personal homes, or you can say what are the appliances you are using, even the transportation system, everything is being calculated there. Here we'll see how to calculate the carbon footprint. So first of all, what we do, already we talked about how formula. Here we'll apply that formula. What is the formula? To calculate the kilowatt hours first of all of your any appliances, like, and then you just multiply it with the emission factor. So what is that, how to calculate the kilowatt hours first? Now, like, how many hours the your equipment is being used, and then for how many days, and then what is the wattage of how much watt it consumes the energy, and then divided by 1000, it will nothing but gives you kilowatts hour. After getting this kilowatt hours, you'll be having area wise or specific regions wise emission factor. So this you just multiply with your emission factor and you'll get total greenhouse gases, that means CO2 emission, that is carbon footprint. So for example purpose, we'll see one appliances to calculate it out. Let us see, there's one appliances which is nothing but a 450 watt, which is being used 6 hours daily for 200 days in a year. So what we do, first of all we'll convert it to the kilowatt hour. So what we have done, 6 hours into 200 days into 450 watts divided by 1000, and we got 540 kilowatts hours of electricity consumption. Now emission factor is given 1.17. when we multiply with this 1.17, we got 631.8 kilogram in a year CO2 emission is there for this equipment. Similarly, this is nothing but some area wise carbon emission factor is given, electricity emission factor is given. So by using, you can find out anywhere according to your area or reasons where you are calculating this carbon emission factor, what is carbon is being emitted to your approximate carbon emission to your current home design. So finally, to design this home, what we are going to do, we are going to make a smart home which should reduce our emission of greenhouse gases. So what we are going to do, first of all we are going to maintain the energy management homes. What is energy management home? That means we are divided into the certain devices, what are the home appliances we are using in our home, we have categorized into certain parts like communication devices, management devices, smart meter, field devices, and computing devices. Now we'll talk about communication devices. So like mobile phones, internet, and all those devices which is being used to communicate is nothing but comes under communication devices. What we can do in this case, we can just select the devices which consume very less power as well as which is work on non-conservation energy sources. Also, it should be smart. Smart means it should not use always power when it is not being used. For example, if you are not attending any devices, then it should switch off its own power. Similarly, if you'll go for the management devices like hard disk drive and home display systems and all, this should also work on very efficient manner. Like here we can use IoT device. IoT device, what it will do, it will just find out the which devices is not utilizing for how many hours, and for that purpose it will nothing but on power, off and off power according to the time, how much time it is being used. Similarly, a smart meter is very much important, because a smart meter will decide this all the electronics, home appliances system being used, either your television, fridge and all those things, then to reduce its power consumption. And also here also we can use the IoT devices to find out that which power, which devices is consuming more energy, so it can be replaced. Now here, if you come about home appliances system, will your 5-star energy efficient device. So for example, AC, instead of using 3-star and 4-star, you just will go for the 5-star, as well as it's better not to use AC and all. So in that case, we can use solar AC, is nowadays is being preferred. So you can use solar power devices, which can very less have very less impact on the environment. Finally, we'll have field devices, some like smart plugs and temperature sensors. Smart plugs is being very useful, because you can use lights, televisions and all those to plug it out, and depending upon your usage, it will switch on and switch off your devices. And finally, some computing devices like your laptops and whatever the devices is being used for calculation, desktops and all. So this has to be also monitored according to their power uses. So what our plan is to use IoT and as well as artificial intelligence and smart devices, all those devices, smart devices, as well as it should be power efficient, and it should uses renewable energy, renewable source of energy, to reduce minimum amount of carbon, so that it could not impact environment as much we are currently doing it out. So thank you for right now. This is the from my side. I have tried to explain the impact of current homes appliances on our environment and how it can be reduced by making a smart home. Thank you.